Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a sliding logo ticker. So if we look here on the Webflow website and you scroll down past the hero section, you can see that they have a bunch of logos that are basically just sliding to the left infinitely. I mean, I'm sure you've seen this across other websites as well. Basically, they put in the logos and then once it hits the end of this track, it seamlessly repeats and just continues going so that it gives the infinite effect. So we're going to do this using CSS, and I'll show you another method using Motion.page as well, in case you have already built some animations in there and just want to keep everything in the same place. But you would be surprised as to how easy this is to accomplish once you understand what's going on behind the scenes, because there are a couple gotchas that might slow you down. And the last thing I want to mention was I have seen a couple other tutorials on how to do this, but in those tutorials, it had a limitation where these logos, or basically any of the images, had to be a perfect width. So they had to fill up only the entire width of the screen and couldn't extend beyond that. And that can work in some cases, like you could probably get it to work in this one. But in some cases, you might have images that are just larger. For example, I use this effect on my wedding website. And I just have this dumb text here, best wedding ever. But if I had to shrink these images so that it fit the screen width, then it just wouldn't look as good. So I wanted to make sure that this worked with whatever size images you have. So let's jump right in. In this example, I am using Bricks Builder, but it doesn't really matter which builder you use as long as there aren't like 1,000 divs and you actually have control over the CSS. And here I have already built our hero section and the content below, just so we have a page to work with. If you look at the Webflow site, yeah, basically we're using this as a starting point, and now we got to slip in the logos. So let's go back over to Bricks, and what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to close these because we don't need them, and then I'm going to go to insert a new section. So here's the new section, and then we don't want a page container because we want our logos to go to the end of the page. So I'm going to get rid of this container. I'm going to go back to the section. I'll just rename it, call it sliding logos, I guess. And then there's a couple things we need to change with the section. Bricks by default sets it to flex and no wrap, but I think it also sets it to column. So we want to make sure that we set it to flex row. And then I think we might just need to center it just in case. It shouldn't really matter, but we're going to center it here. And then now inside of this section, we're going to add a div. So this is going to be our first container for all the logos. So I'm just going to call this track. And then I'm going to give it a class as well of ticker. If I could type ticker track. Perfect. And then what we're going to do here is, because we're putting the logos inside, we actually do want this to be flex, so flex, and then we want the logos to be in a row. And then again, we're going to make sure that everything is centered vertically, and we're going to make sure that the logos start on the left. So that should be good for now. Actually, there's one other thing. Bricks Builder sets a max width of all the divs to 100%, and because the logos can extend past the screen, we don't want that. So we're just going to change max width to unset. Cool, so we did that all on the class, which is important because we'll have another track shortly. And then all we need to do now is start adding some images. So I'm gonna go add an image. And then I'm gonna select one of the logos. It doesn't matter. Click insert. And then we're gonna add a class to this as well. So we'll call this ticker image. And then from here, so there's one thing that's very important to do, otherwise you'll waste probably an hour and 13 minutes or whatever it was. Make sure the loading is set to eager, because if it's set to lazy, then the entire width of the track will change as images become loaded and the animation just won't work properly. So definitely make sure that they're not lazy loaded. The other thing we're going to do here is set the sizing on the images. So just trying to think, we could do width auto and height to, I don't know exactly, but let's try 60 pixels. Okay, so that's not too bad. And then also I'd like to set a padding on the images. So we could do something like 2 rem and actually I'm going to go 1 rem. That might be too much. 1 rem and 1 rem. So that just gives a little space around our logo. And normally I'd want to do this using a gap on the parent wrapper, but you don't want to do that here because of how the ticker kind of like reaches the end and then restarts. If there's a gap, you'll notice some jitter. So make sure you're only using padding to give spacing in between the logos. So what I'm going to do next is make sure I have the class, and I'm just going to start duplicating these and adding in the rest of our images. Okay, so we've added a bunch of images now, but these are actually way too big. So I'm just going to make them a little bit smaller. Go back to the class and maybe I'll do something like 32. Yeah, that might be a bit closer. Maybe I can even go to like 36, something like that. And then the spacing, it's okay, but I'd actually like a little bit more spacing as well. So I'm going to go to 1.5 rem on both sides. There, I think that looks better. And then let's save and see what this looks like on the front end. So yeah, perfect. We have all our logos and the section scrolls, but that's fine for now. So let's go back to Bricks Builder. And then what we want to do here is duplicate this track. So I'm just going to duplicate this. And then actually, there is one more thing we need to do because Bricks Builder has these flex settings set by default. Basically, we do not want the track to grow and we don't want it to shrink either. And that way they won't start overlapping each other, and then we can leave flex spaces as it is. And let's go back to the front end. Perfect. So now if we look, actually, yeah, this is much better because now it starts where it's supposed to start. And then if we scroll, we can see that it has the rest of the logos. And this is where the second track begins. So yeah, ends at PWC, starts at BBDO. So everything looks good here. And now at this point, we can make sure that our section has an overflow hidden. That way we don't see the second track. So let's go to style, overflow, hidden. Let's click save, make sure that's all good. Perfect. So this looks better. Now we just got to get it moving. Method number one is to create a CSS animation. So let's go back to the builder, and then you can do this wherever you have your custom CSS, but I'm just going to add it to the sliding logos element. And then if we scroll down to CSS, I need to make the animation. So we can call the animation at keyframes, and you can see it gives you a little hint here about keyframes. And then we'll call this ticker. Then we'll open up the brackets and then we start our keyframes. So at 0%, we want to do transform and then translate X at 0%. So basically we're telling it to move nowhere at 0%, and then we'll close that. And then at 100%, so once the animation is done, then, sorry, it's a little hard to see with my mic sometimes. 100%, we're going to do the same thing. So I'm just going to copy that over and then switch this to -100%. So that will move things completely to the left off the screen. And then we're going to close this entire animation. And then now we need to add the animation to our ticker track. We could add this to the track itself, but it doesn't really matter. We're just doing some custom CSS here. So if you remember, we called the track ticker track. So I'm just going to go back here and type in ticker track and then open up the brackets, and then we'll use the animation property and then we'll include the name. So ticker, we want it, we'll play around with the timing, but let's say 30 seconds for now. And then we want it to go linear because we don't want any easing. We want it just to be like a straight, simple motion. And then we'll say infinite, so that just continues to loop. So let's close that. And as you can see, it already just started working. So let's save. Perfect. And then go to the front end, refresh. Cool. So basically at this point, let's just wait to see. Here's where the ticker started. So, I mean, let's just wait a second and make sure everything looks seamless once it gets to the front here, but everything's looking good so far. I probably should have sped this up just so we weren't waiting around. And nice, as you can see, it made it to the front and everything looks perfectly seamless here. So that's how you do it with custom CSS. The other method, which I was going to show you, was with motion.page. So I'll just turn this off really quick, go back to the builder, and I'm going to just change the class name to something different so that it doesn't actually affect it. And click save here. And then I'm going to go over to motion.page, create a new timeline. We'll call this ticker. And yeah, you'll see how fast this is to do. We'll scroll down. We just need to find our track so we can use the selector. And then we might just need to type it in because I forgot to add a padding. Yeah, let's just type it in. So we'll just type in ticker track. Perfect. And then we just need to do exactly what we did with a custom CSS. So translate 0 because this is the from. And then 2, we want it to go to -100. And then the couple things that we need to do is make sure it repeats -1 times. That means it goes infinitely. And then the easing, we want to not have default. We want to set this to none so that there is no, it's just a straight linear animation. So if we hit save timeline here, then we just need to adjust the timing on this as well. I'll just set that there so that we're not waiting forever. Ticker track, yeah, everything should be good. So let's just check the front end. Where is this here? And yeah, so here's the motion page version. This one's obviously going a lot faster. You would just extend the timeline, but as you can see, everything, here's the beginning. It's going perfectly smooth. That's it for this video. If you found this tutorial helpful, be sure to hit the subscribe button. That way I know that these videos are actually worth making. And if you're interested, I also publish a bi-weekly newsletter called The Lab Report, where I share other tutorials like this and talk about everything going on in WordPress and web design. You can find that over at newpulselabs.com/newsletter. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you found it helpful.